Okay, welcome back now.
Yes.
Yeah.
Welcome back, everybody.
Welcome back!
Did you say Did you say because you saw this bird victim?
No! He said to his girlfriend!
Sorry. You're very cute.
I said to you, by the way, everybody. When I said that one time, that was only in relation to Steven's and not, in fact, to Hanako. Please do not kill me. Please do not burn me at a stake.
Too soon.
My house cannot handle any more tarring and feathering. These walls are about to collapse in on me.
Which is you shouldn't kill him that way either. I look over my shoulder and see Hanako peering timidly into the classroom.
After most this episode, we're breaking up.
Okay. I guess this episode's going on forever. Most of her body hidden behind the door.
Hey! Playing delinquent again?
Hanako blushes hard at Misha's straightforward jab, even if it was only in jest.
Blessed?
Yeah, she comes in and says that.
No!
Shizune stares at her probingly, causing Hanako to look down, starting to back away to the point where only her fingers can be wrapped nervously around the edge of the door. Maybe she is showing her dislike for Hanako by association to her dislike of Lily. It appears so, and Hanako probably knows it as well. What is it, Hanako?
Has Lily been here? Sorry, I haven't seen... What? Sato?
Sato.
Sato.
Lily
she
Sato.
Came by in the morning, though.
Hanako keeps looking uneasily at Shizune, who stares back at her with her usual studying gaze. What is she trying to do?
Be a bully?
Of course, Shizune isn't going to look away, and she is intimidating enough as it is, so I could only imagine how terrified Hanako would be. It is a little uncomfortable watching Hanako's reaction to Shizune's normal behavior. This is what happens when two people of two different extremes meet, it seems.
Do you know where she is? If she has any sense in her head, she's in her classroom, working on their festival project, but who knows where that woman is loitering at.
Whoa.
Jesus.
Nice one, Shizune. Nice one, Misha.
Good one, you fucking stupid bitch.
You need to find her. She was looking for you in the morning, but I guess you have missed each other. She waits a little without answering the simple question, looking awfully like she's not sure if it's proper to answer such a question.
Yeah.
I can come with you.
Yeah, get the fuck out.
If it's okay. Hanako nods fractionally, still on guard, her shoulders stiff like wood. I get the feeling that she might be more comfortable by herself after all. I'm stiff like wood. She
my
has
penis.
Really
my penis.
Get it? She has this troubled expression she seems to wear almost constantly, one that makes me constantly be on guard myself. I wonder why. I kind of understand why she always seems to be so wary, or maybe she's more like why there could be a person like her. But I still have no idea how I should act around such a person.
Oh, she's a normal person.
Dinner time soon. Were you planning to eat with Lily? She nods slightly. So she must have been trying to get to the cafeteria. Well, there is something
cafeteria.
For a dinner crowd that's just for the...
Cafeteria?
Yeah. It's not as bad as because dinner time is longer than lunch hour, but I can understand why Hanako could be discouraged from growing on. I pick up my bag, excuse me, Hanako, and we take our leave. Hanako skips a little my initial pace, so I slow down to match her speed. Doesn't take long for us to be walking at a comfortable pace down. It almost feels like we're going for a stroll together, something that I can't say I've really done before with a goyal.
What a fucking loser.
Dweeb.
Fucking idiot.
Hanako doesn't seem to be thinking the same thing, though. Even though we are walking at the same pace, she never comes within arm's reach of me. I guess she's still a little uncomfortable around me, given how shy she is. There doesn't seem to be much helping it, at least for now. By the time we arrive at the cafeteria,
the lily. Sorry.
Hanako's head sinks even lower than usual. Boop. Have you looked somewhere else already?
Just at the library I was reading.
So she's
What a fucking loser.
So what exactly? Well, if I had to guess, she'd be in her own.
Right.
With the slightest of nods, Hanako agrees with my reasoning. Gosh, she's so awkward.
Stop being mean!
Like I needed double-layered silk gloves with padding to even interact with her. Some small talk might help her become a bit more used to me, but it isn't hard to tell that the science between us is hovering on the edge in both of our minds.
You know how you talk to an introvert?
You scream louder.
No, you talk to them like a normal fucking person. Jesus Christ.
You and Lily usually hang out together after class, right?
Yes.
I'm not quite sure that I expected from her answer, nor why I even asked the question. That was rather obvious, after all. She doesn't seem like the type to cultivate a social circle either, so I suspect that Lily may be her only friend. God, you're a loser. Just kidding.
You guys are mean! You guys are mean.
Must be a pain being in different classes, I'm guessing. She gives a sharp, almost reflexive nod. Compared to Lily's careful thought about her actions and speech, Anako hastens to make her answers as prompt and short as possible.
Lily comes by the classroom, though, even when she's busy.
Well, she's smiling. She gives a smile as she says it, appreciating the fact that Lily goes out of her way to help her. It's pretty cute, really. There isn't really any need to say more. Both of us are content that the discussion's reached.
She's cute. I love her. Steven, love her. Don't fuck the dumb bitch. She's a dumb bitch.
As we ascend the stairs back to the lobby, we are met by a group of students heading downstairs like a school of fish moving from one feeding area to the other.
Haven't you fucked enough dumb bitches in your life?
Not enough.
She's pretty smart, actually.
They seem to be keeping to themselves, but they're...
Yeah, but she's a bitch, okay?
You all right?
Because you're smart doesn't make you better than anybody else, you fucking cunt. Just keep going.
Okay. The students pass us without much of a second glance, and Hanako takes up position to my side again as we are entering the building. Her reprieve from her anxiety all but snatched away. Even as we climb towards the third floor, she doesn't seem to relax. It isn't as if I've never known a shy person before, or even shy girls, but Hanako seems to be pretty far beyond what I call normal in her fear of other people. If it weren't for Lily acting as a mediator, I doubt Hanako would be able. She seems
pleased. You know what the term for fear of people is? It's agoraphobic.
I thought agoraphobics was going outside in general.
Yeah, I thought that was going outside.
Oh wait, is that true? Yeah. Which one's the fear of people then?
Similar.
Let me look it up.
The rest of the walk to Lily's classroom continued in a strange silence, while I rue her inability to socialize at all.
Do you think she's agoraphobic, though? Because that's where, like, fire is, and where she got lit on fire.
I assume it's inside, yeah. Anthropophobia.
Anthropophobia. That's what she's got.
I think. Something like that. I'm bad with words that Steven, have too many letters in them. Put it on the screen, Steven.
If it's incorrect, put the right one on the screen, and also call both of us stupid.
No,
in case we both got wrong.
I'm right. I just don't know if I pronounced it right, but I am right. So put it on the screen so everyone can see it.
It's actually lactosophobia.
Okay. Well, if Lainey isn't also getting called stupid, I don't want to get called stupid either, Steven.
Here's the thing. I am stupid, so call Joe stupid.
Who's Steven, stupid? Let us know in the comments.
Steven, edit in calling your stupid yourself. You.
I'm stupid.
Yes.
After we make our way up the stairs, the noise coming from Lily's classroom is audible from halfway down the hallway. I wasn't expecting such a din at all. Well, I guess we found her. This wasn't hard. Did Hanako come here first and then come for me? Well, if that's true, then at least she's starting to trust me a little. That can only be a good thing. Eventually, the two of us reached the door. Class 3-2. With Hanako less than subtly positioning herself behind me, I opened the door. It's really busy in here. Inside is a hive of activity, seemingly every student in the class talking at once as they work hurriedly in their separate tasks. Going by the paint cans, decorations, and banners being made, it must be for the upcoming school festival. I guess my first priority should be finding Lily. Lily!
So, there. She was in class Trumbly Doubloon.
Yep. I was going to say something, but I couldn't remember how you worded it. Finding her among the din is surprisingly easy, not the least because of her looks. With a couple of students gathered around her as she stands in the front of the class, she seems to be in charge of the preparations, or at least busy organizing them. Carefully negotiating a path through the various students hunched over the floor for a lack of desk space, I raise a hand entirely out of habit as we reach Lily. Hi, Lily. She perks her head up as she breaks off, talking to a noticeably smaller girl who must be her classmate, trying to listen as best she can.
Oh, right. Sorry, who?
Sorry, Hisao. I have Hanako, too.
Hey.
Lily is a big girl.
Yeah, she's tall. She's tall. She's gargantuan. She's like an Amazon woman you can climb like a tree.
Do you think she's taller than Hisao?
Probably. Ooh,
what a fucking loser.
No, not a loser. Climb her like a tree. That's hot.
Ooh.
Yeah.
She's pretty skittish considering the number of people who's around. It isn't too hard to work out why. Lily takes
she would
moment.
Never even see it coming.
Yeah, I'm so shocked.
Lily takes a moment to pause to assess the situation before turning to the other student once again.
For the moment, just ask Moria for his advice. Kenji's busy with painting one of the banners already.
Kenji's
in her class, by the way.
Oh, so he's familiar with hot Amazon babe, and he mad about it.
Well,
he's mostly blind.
Yeah, I guess that's true. Okay. Right. Because this is the class that caters to the blind
students. Forgot that he's mostly blind. I just thought he was here because he's an incel.
Not...
Which should be a disability.
Visually, it's not like entirely blind students. Visually impaired.
Yeah,
that's
like I know that he's like legally blind, but he's not like all the way blind.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Okay, sorry. I forgot. I thought he was just a naked incel who's trying to fuck you.
I have a legally blind neighbor, and like one time I walked past him and I like held the door open for him and it was like all fine and dandy, and when I closed the door he called me the N-word. I was just like so taken aback that I just couldn't react. I was like
did he tell you about like the feminist conspiracy too?
He's kind of an asshole.
It's like why are you racist? You're blind.
I'm not the biggest fan of him.
Yeah, he's kind of a dick.
Yeah, like you can't see. So why does it fucking matter? I don't get it. Whatever. Everyone sucks.
It's bizarre. I was just still taking it back. It's like, wait, but you shouldn't be. Oh god. Anyway, a quick nod and she bounces off fingers and carefully sliding along the wall's face for orientation. Wait, Kenji? That Kenji. I quickly turn around, sweat's dripping down my brow, leaning side to side to see past Hanako. Sure enough, in a corner room, Kenji is hunched over a sheet of cloth as he paints it. His eyes remain only inches from the brush, reminding me of how close he had to be to make out my face when I met him.
To make out with my face.
Oh.
You know what? Steven, draw that. Draw Kenji drawing. That fuck. That's too much work. Don't do that. I'm sorry. That's too much of that. You've already been doing amazing edits. I gotta compliment you on that, by the way. You're everybody, okay. give some applause to Steven. And like edit in like people cheering for you.
Woo!
Yeah, just like a little bit. Sorry about that. Our class doesn't have many students with even partial eyesight, so they're in high demand.
Yeah, remember this when you go, ugh, about me again. Remember how supportive and nice I am to you.
That's right, class 3-2, trouble blah blah blah. Students for the poor vision, preparing for the festival must be pretty arduous.
What was it, Trumbly Balloons?
Trumbly Wumblies.
Trumbly Dubloon. Like,
Trumbly Wumblies?
Need a hand? I can give you help if you need some. Maybe Hanako could too. Chance to set her mind on something would do a great. But I doubt she has the courage to ask outright. She quickly nods in affirmation afterwards, so I'm confident I made the right move. Lily gives a noticeable sigh of relief.
Well, that's good. This might actually get finished before everyone goes off to dinner. Would you be able to help the person painting the main banner? It's a big task for him to do, but nobody else can
God
help.
God damn it!
Kenji? Sure. She seems surprised that I know him. I can't really blame her.
I take it you've met.
Our rooms in the dorm are right next to each other. Hard to miss each other, really.
Oh, she's cute.
Well, it's good to see you're getting friends so fast.
Friends? I wonder if that's the right word to use for him.
Seen his boner and he asked me for money and I wouldn't share a pizza.
We were homies at this point. Hanako's silence during the proceedings reminds me of the reason I put her up to the... We'll go help him then. He knows what he's doing, right?
That's right. Just ask him if you have any problems.
God.
Chorusing in a
sense. No, that was a good British.
Hanako and I begin another trek across the classroom. Kenji sits crouched on the floor, his gaze fixed on the white calico in front of him.
Fucking Harry Potter looking ass. Steven, for this whole time, will you put a little lightning bolt scar on his head?
A little communist scar? Saw a picture of that. Is Harry Potter showing off his scar and it's just a communist symbol?
He's showing off his scar and it's just a swastika like fucking Charles Manson.
Oh no.
Crazy
oh,
no. ass.
Hey Kenji. No answer. He continues dragging his paint soaked brush along the large half painted kanji that's sketched. Kenji?
Huh? What? Who is it?
If this is the way he treats his class members, it's no small wonder he's working on this alone.
Yeah, you think this man
it's
has
me,
friends?
But also, because they're also, like, all... Like, he's one of the only partially... Like, he has some vision.
Yeah.
Right. I know that, man. What are you doing here, though?
His dismissive attitude annoys me.
Good! He's annoying!
He must be that type. They really get focused on his work, hating to be disturbed by anyone until he's done, I suppose.
Get over it, that's life.
While we talk, the sound of Hanako's footsteps as she walks out from behind me reminds me that she's here.
Is Kenji gonna be mean to her?
We're gonna find out. I was just about to help with the banner. Hanako and I, that is.
Hello.
Oh. Or hey, I guess that's okay.
As soon as Hanako enters the equation, his demeanor takes complete about face. His sudden faux hospitality is slightly unsettling. Oh, right, women. On second thoughts, this might not have been a great idea after all.
No, don't put her through this. She deserves none of his grossness.
Hanako and I grudgingly set ourselves down on the opposite side of the cloth banner out to Kenji. Nothing the several
Noting.
Small patrons... Class 3-2, noodle stall?
Noodle stall?
You guys selling noodles at the festival on Sunday?
Noodles?
Yeah, some stalls outside or something.
Noodles?
Or something. His noncommittal nature sparks a fair amount of suspicion on my behalf. The task at hand comes first, though. So.
Oh, yeah. I might be explaining this because, like, you sounded, like, a bit surprised about, like, noodles. But, like, sometimes, like, in like, Japan, they have students do festivals where they sell food and... run like haunted houses and shit inside
yeah
the school.
I figured it was something like that. I really like noodles. So I was excited that they were serving noodles. Also, noodle is a cute and fun word to say.
Okay, cool.
But yeah, I figured that's what it was. It was like I figured they were in like Japan or something. So it was like more of a like a culture thing. But yeah, like because we've done festivals in my school and shit. Obviously not noodles, but there's been like hamburgers and hot dogs and shit, you know?
That's fucking great.
Super American, you know?
Hamburger noodles.
Hamburger noodle. Ew.
Oh, I was like hamburger. So how do you want to split this? We do borders while you do the text, or do you want to switch and do the borders?
Text is mine, you do borders.
You have surprisingly strong feelings on this topic. As I reach over to grab a brush, I notice Hanako's already debating between colors to use. By the time I put the brush to cloth, she's already started a delicate pattern. Looks like my idea of taking her mind off everyone around her works. With a dark blue stroke, the three of us silently get to work. Not before Kenji takes advantage of Hanako's working to lead towards me and whisper conspicuously, though.
Conspiratorially. Okay, man, why are you here?
Hanako wanted some help to find Lily, that's all. He apparently disapproves my motivations.
I get it. It looks like I misjudged you. You're infiltrating them, aren't you? Going deep undercover?
I should have guessed letting the truth slip by him would probably be better than outright lying or annoying him in any case. Is that why you're here?
Obviously. It sucks, but there's no way better way to get intel than going in yourself. We gotta stick together, man. This is a harsh school, a harsh world.
Yeah, very harsh. He misses my true meaning as he leans back, satisfied I'm sympathetic to his cause. Better get down to work. His theme song is... it's suiting. I love it. It's good.
I love Kenji's theme. It's so good. Who's your favorite, theme song?
So far, it's Kenji's.
So far. Yeah? I love Rin's. My favorite parody.
Oh, what it's called. A surprise. Joe loves Rin.
Looks like I am too. Good job. The two of us connect up the lines of our patterns. Mine being as close a copy as I could to manage of hers.
Steven, who's your favorite?
Theme?
No, lady.
Lady? It's a secret.
It's a deaf girl, isn't it? Oh.
Deaf. Is it next time?
No.
Aside from Hanako and myself, there's only Kenji left finishing off a sign, as well as Lily and a couple students talking among themselves in the classroom. Blah, 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 blah. Looking at my watch, it's no surprise. Getting late as shit. Need a hand? Whoosh. Offer a hand to Hanako, which she uses to get herself up.
Aww.
As she does, I can't help but glance at her wrist. If her scars extend even to there, just how much of her body was burned? I feel a pang of guilt about it, however, she quickly covers her wrist with her other hand.
Aww.
Looks good, doesn't it? She looks surprised for a moment before noticing that I mean the banner.
It does, I guess.
Her smile shows that she feels a slight sense of pride in the result, just as I do.
She's so cute!
With the floor significantly neater for the decorations being placed on desks and shelves, it's much easier to get to Lily as we cross the room. We finish the banner. I guess that's all that needs to be done. Lily gives an appreciative nod.
Thank you, Hosao. Hanako, if there's anything, any way I can thank you.
About $60. I will, yeah. It's fine. Beats sitting in my room.
Masturbating.
Yeah.
I don't mind
do you
either.
Do you want to listen to Weezer with me, Lily? Do you want to listen to Bare Naked Ladies with me? Lily.
It's been 1 week since you looked at me. Oh, insensitive. Insensitive.
She nods before suddenly remembering one last person.
Oh, is Kenji still here?
We don't need to worry about him.
Just as I open my mouth, Kenji gives the answer from the other side of the room.
Yeah, just finished.
He's like shitting on the floor.
He's just zipping up his fly, just masturbated in the corner.
He carefully slides his sign into the empty section.
That's what he fucking pinned the side with.
Sorry. before quickly walking past us and out the door.
See you, man.
Bye.
Idiot. Fucking hate that guy.
The remaining two students say their goodbyes to Lily before taking their cue to leave as well, leaving only the three of us.
Just the three of us.
Well, I guess it's everyone.
I hope we don't have to do anything like that again.
What, work with Kenji?
Working past school time?
Indeed. The class's plans this year were ambitious, maybe too ambitious.
This doll looks nice, though.
She's right. It shows that a lot of work's gone into them.
My, my. I'm sure a lot of us would be glad to hear that. At least now there's not much work to do until the festival later. A lot of us would be glad to hear that because we can't see the stalls ourselves because we're blind.
She's really pissed. Okay.
I'm glad it does. I wouldn't know.
Why the fuck did they have us paint?
It's getting pretty late. Should we go to next time on the podcast?
Okay.
This time.
No time.
This time.
No time.
All right.
Okay. Good episode. This was a good episode.
It was a good episode. Make sure you end the episode with us talking about how good the episode was.
Such a good fucking episode. My pants are just so sticky and moist. Yes.
I am sitting in a puddle.
Puddle of
sploosh.
Okay.
Yeah.
My squirty birdie's going off, Steven.
Ew.